Hello guys, today I'm going to show you how to make a moon in Blender. This is for beginners, so this is a very simple process. Now let's get started. This is the default cube. Now delete it by pressing X and then delete. Now let's add a UV sphere, press Shift A and then mesh and then UV sphere. Now bring it to the center, press N for its location coordinates and set everything to 0. So now it's at the center. Now scale it a little bit. Now go to the modifier section and then add modifier and then subdivision surface. So this modifier makes many subdivisions for our meshes. Now press smooth for have a smoother look. Now let's edit the light source, press this light button and then go to the object data button and press sun. Now as you can see we have a dotted line, so press N for its properties and then set the rotation value to 245. The value of X is important, so we can leave the Y and Z values. Now select this UV sphere and now we can go switch to compositing mode, drag this so that we can have splitted screens. Now go to the node editor, now switch from Blender render to cycles render. Now press N this to close this panel. Now press new for properties and zoom it a little bit. Now this diffuse shader is important, make it completely black. Now press Shift A and then search for emission. Now press now deselect everything and press Control and drag this to cut this node. Now we will use it later. Now press Shift A and then shader and then mix shader. Now plug in these two nodes into the mix shader input. Now press Shift A and then texture and then noise texture. Now we need a math node to mix both the colors. Now press Shift A, converter and then math. Now plug in the noise texture's color input to the top input and then set the value to multiply and then plug in the value to the factor input. Now set the value to 2 and then the emission value to 0.8. now plug the shader to the surface. Now let's have a rendered view of this. Now go to the viewpoint shading menu and then render. Boom, as you can see this is the moon. So we can have we can play with these values and get different values for the moon. You can also put this to 0.8 or something like that and we can have different values. These values determine the properties of the moon. Set the strength to 1 and then this value. Now we can have different values, so now put this emission value to 1 and the multiply value to 1.8 or 1.4, anything you want. Actually what I want to do is to have a moon which has less black color. See, now we'll have a better moon. So we are done with the compositing. Now let's add some further details and now drag this to the right to exit. Now let's set up the camera and select this camera and then press Shift and right click on this moon and press Control T and then track to constraint. Now press 0 for camera perspective view and zoom it out. Press N and then lock camera to view. So zoom it out so that the whole thing is visible. You can also add further details like backgrounds and everything else. So let's add a background, go to the world and then use notes button. And now press environment texture. Now set the directory where you have the image. I'm going to use background stars image. You can find a link to it in the description. And now we can have the render view. Wow, now it's looking awesome. As you can see, this is somewhat like a realistic moon. Now you can add further more details like rotation and revolution by adding keyframes to it. Go to solid view and make sure that it is on keyframe number 1. Now select this UV sphere and press I and then rotation, and go to 70th frame and press R, then Z, then 360 and then enter. Now press I and then rotation. Now this will rotate until all the 360 degrees, and if you render it, you will get a beautiful results.